Crossrail is more than the 8 tunnel boring machines and 10 drives that they'll do. Across the whole of London, here at Stepney Green as an example, we're creating these caverns using sprayed concrete lining, which allow us to create the platform tunnels for the stations, the turnouts here at Stepney Green, and those allow the TBMs to come through after we've done this and gets a head start on the station construction schedule. These caverns, there's two of them, are 17 meters wide by 15 meters high by 50 meters long, which makes them some of the largest structures that will be built with sprayed concrete lining in the world.
We're currently in the westbound step plate junction here at Stepney Green. We're some 40 meters below ground, and behind me you can see that the final stages of construction of the westbound cavern. Sprayed concrete lining has got many advantages, not least of which is that you can excavate a variety of diameters and a variety of layouts in terms of you can do tunnels with 90 degree bends, etc. You can't do that with the TBM.
We're constructing two caverns. These caverns form the meeting point between the Drive Y and Drive Z tunnel boring machines that are passing from Puddingwell Lane and Canary Wharf through here, Stepney Green, all the way through to Farringdon Station. Everything that we in the caverns has been sprayed. So all the concrete is batched on site. We have our own site batch plant. That concrete is then taken into the down the shaft. We hoist it down with a crane. We've got two cranes here, one is a backup. The concrete is then carried in on small remixer trucks, rough terrain remixer trucks, and then reversed up onto the back of a sprayed concrete machine. It's bespoke spraying equipment. Then the concrete is then sprayed, or is then combined with compressed air and additive at the nozzle, and then sprayed onto the clay surface.
The use of sprayed concrete lining to create large tunnel caverns like this is not new. What's new is the scale that we're doing it at on Crossrail. Between the different stations here at Stepney Green, at the various portal areas, there's probably more sprayed concrete lining work here on Crossrail than on any one project that I can think of in the history of tunneling.
The works here at Stepney Green, we have a total team, the contractor and Crossrail, of right about 200 people. That sounds a lot at first, but that's on 24/7 continuous working. So we've got teams of surveyors, engineers, the designer, the contractors team, the supervisors, the managers, the agents, the workforce itself, highly skilled, highly competent workforce, and we've managed to build a team, fully integrated, collaborative, and we've been able to deliver a world-class structure.